the start. Makes no difference who you are.
Each week as you enter this timeless land, one of these many worlds will open to you. Frontierland. Tall tales and true from the legendary past. Tomorrowland. Promise of things to come. Adventureland. The wonder world of nature's own realm. Fantasyland. The happiest kingdom of them all. Monsters of the Deep. And now your host, Walt Disney.
Down through the years, monsters have played many leading parts in our pictures. So many, in fact, that we've had to devote this entire room in our research department to the subject. Later on, you're going to meet two of our star performers. Monstro the Whale from the story of Pinocchio, and the Giant Squid from our feature production, 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. But first, let's talk about monsters in general and sea monsters in particular. Suppose we begin with monsters of the past. Under the sea. But today we know that the giant squid does exist. And he's every bit as villainous and fantastic as Verne described him. Our file on the squid begins very much like the sea serpent file, with eyewitness accounts. 1861, the French corvette Electon reports killing the giant squid with cannon fire. A few years later, a Captain Jean Danes tells of a squid seizing a member of his crew. 1873, fishermen battle a giant squid and chop off one of the tentacles. We have many such unconfirmed reports, but now our case for the giant squid gains weight, the weight of physical evidence. Exhibit A is the squid's mortal enemy, the whale. Many seafaring men have reported witnessing scenes like this, a titanic struggle between these two monsters of the deep. And yet these stories sound unbelievable. After all, whales run up to 90 feet in length and weigh upwards of 100 tons. Anything on earth or under the sea big enough to tangle with a fellow like this? The answer is definitely yes. For whales have been caught bearing the imprint of giant suction cups, and in their bellies, beaks from the giant squids have been found. Now here's a photograph of one. A squid reconstructed from this beak would measure 38 feet, but we don't have to rely on guesswork. All the theories about the giant squid were proven once and for all when one was caught alive in Trinity Bay, Newfoundland. Its body measured 9.5 feet. And here's a photograph of one tentacle which was preserved in a museum. It's 30 feet long. This enormous tentacle, by the way, could explain a lot of things, like sea serpents and such. Let's take this picture of one of the sea serpents we showed you a while back and superimpose our giant squid. See what happens? Here's an eyewitness drawing of a sea serpent fighting a whale. But was it really this? In other words, whenever there's talk of sea serpents, it might be well to look for a giant squid. And that's exactly what we had to do when we decided to bring Jules Verne's 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea to the screen. Now, of course, we couldn't capture and train the real article. So we decided we'd have to build a giant squid. But before we talk about our full-scale version of this fellow, let's clear up once and for all the difference between a squid and an octopus. Many people confuse the two. The octopus is comparatively harmless, has a soft, almost shapeless body, 8 tentacles, and spends most of its time crawling about on the ocean floor. Its movements are rather slow, at least compared to the squid's. We're told that when a squid grasps his prey, its tentacles move faster than anything in nature, faster even than the flick of a lizard's tongue. This is a very small specimen, by the way, but physically he's exactly like his colossal cousin, the giant squid. A long cigar-shaped body, 10 tentacles, 2 long ones for catching its victim, 8 others to grasp it and hold it while it tears it apart with its beak. So between the two, the squid and the octopus, it's the squid who's the real villain. In fact, Peter Lorre, who plays a very sympathetic role in 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, claims that the squid got the role that's usually reserved for him. Now, to construct our squid, we had to first have a plan. So we laid out these scale drawings with the aid of technical directors and then animated its movements forward and backward. The squid used a different propelling force for each direction. Forward, he swims slowly by means of the large fins on the sides of his body. But when he wants to go places in a hurry, he shifts into reverse and original jet propulsion. He does this by swallowing water and forcing it through a propelling tube located under his mouth. He uses this same tube to shoot out a smokescreen of sepia ink. As a matter of fact, it's the same ink used in making these drawings. Now, the best of plans are only beginning. It's the result that counts. So now let's see that result. Let's move over on the 20,000 League set and meet this giant squid in person. Kirk Douglas will handle the introductions. But first, he has a whale of a tale to tell.
Got a whale of a tale to tell you, lads. A whale of a tale or two about the flapping fish and the girls I've loved on nights like this with the moon above. A whale of a tale, and it's all true, I swear by my tattoo. There was Mermaid Minnie, met her down in Madagascar. She would kiss me anytime that I would ask her. Then one evening, her flame of love blew out. Blow me down and pick me up, she swapped me for a trout.
Got a whale of a tale to tell you, lads. A whale of a tale or two about the flapping fish and the girls I've loved on nights like this with the moon above. A whale of a tale, and it's so true, I swear by my tattoo.
There was Typhoon Tessie, met her on the coast of Java. When we kissed, I bubbled up like molten lava. Then she gave me the scare of my young life. Blow me down and pick me up, she was the captain's wife.
Got a whale of a tale to tell you, lads. A whale of a tale or two about the flapping fish and the girls I've loved on nights like this with the moon above. A whale of a tale, and it's all true, I swear by my tattoo.
Cut it. Thank you, gentlemen. Take us down.
Rosie, how high up are the jacks?
Start gathering up the equipment for a move, boys.
A whale of a tale to tell you, lads. Hello. You know, this has been quite a picture for me. I've never been braver. I fight sharks, cannibals, giant squid, women. But the bravest thing I do is to open my mouth and sing. Believe me, with a voice like mine, it takes a lot of courage. Prop men. I won't break it. Always afraid I'm gonna break something. You know, it's been an exciting experience here in Disneyland, where a wooden puppet called Pinocchio turns into a human. Peter Pan teaches children to fly. But my greatest thrill in this land of miracles was actually walking along the floor of the ocean with Captain Nemo and the crew of the Nautilus. Phew, what an experience. Oh, this is interesting. I want you to see this. Rosie, would you mind placing that against the ship for a minute?
You bet. Over here, Marty.
You see, everything's different here. Now, every other picture I've worked in, you could tuck the script under your arm and walk home. But here, oh no. It takes two men to carry a single page. Really. Look. It's what you might call a king-size comic strip. After Dick, our director, lays out the action, the artists sketch the whole script with these drawings. Now, this is the squid fight that you're going to see.
Oh.
Quite a monster, huh? Now, just before this scene, I've been down in the glory hole.
Kirk, we're ready.
All right, I'll be right with you. I want to explain to the people. There's been a tremendous explosion.
We're lined up and waiting.
All right. I'll be right there.
We're waiting.
Clock watcher. I'm sorry, I'd like to tell you more about this, but I can't hold up production. Well, I've got an idea. Hey, Pete. Peter.
Huh?
Come over here, will you?
What is it, Kirk?
Listen, would you do me a favor? You all know Mr. Peter Lorre, a fine actor.
Yes, but I can't sing.
I knew we had something in common. Listen, Pete, I've got to go over to stage 3. Would you tell these people more about the squid fight?
But I'm not in this fight. You know, I'd much rather tell them about the scene with our fight.
No,
you know,
there's no time for that, Peter. Mr. Disney's orders.
Oh, well, all right.
Thanks, and I'll see you later.
But Paul Lucas and I, we're not in this fight. I still think I'd rather tell you about
it. Peter!
All right. Well, before the giant squid attacks, there's an underwater explosion on a submarine. And because of that, the power goes off. So Captain Nemo, that's James Mason. Captain Nemo orders the submarine to surface. And now, up from the murky deeps, rise the most horrible deep, the most dreaded of all sea monsters, the giant squid. There's no escape for the disabled submarine, and no escape for Nemo and his crew either. Now they must fight it out, man to beast. That'll give you a small idea. I'm sure that you'll want to see the whole story in a theater for yourself. One thing I must say, it's by far the most exciting picture I've ever worked in. Oh, I can hardly wait to see myself. So if in the audience you happen to sit next to someone that's killing himself with delight, don't get scared. Could be me.